Okay, maybe you just got back from your doctor's office for a routine follow-up on your thyroid, and you were now told that in addition to having thyroid disease, you now have a fatty liver. Is this something that you need to be concerned about? How did a fatty liver develop? How serious is a fatty liver? And did my thyroid cause my fatty liver? Okay, well maybe you're not wondering about that one, but that's exactly what I'm gonna talk about today, because it's an important thing that's happening with people with thyroid disease. Well, hey there, I'm Dr. Hagmeyer, and today we're looking at fatty liver disease and the connection it has to thyroid disorders, why it starts, as well as some of the important things you need to consider when it comes to the treatment of a fatty liver. And at the end of the video, I'll also get into some of the most important dietary strategies to help treat fatty liver, and hopefully some of these strategies can help you reverse it. With that said, let's just jump into some of the basics as far as what a fatty liver is. Well, just as the name implies, fatty liver refers to abnormally high levels of fats, otherwise known as lipids, that have become concentrated in your liver. Now, in past, researchers really felt that this was a problem that only happened in people who overindulge in alcohol. But then when patients were asked about how much alcohol they drink per day, per week, per month, they had to create a whole new category for people who didn't drink and have fatty livers. So hence the name non-alcoholic fatty liver disease was created. Now in 2020, a study stated that in the last 20 years, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease has become one of the most common liver diseases worldwide, where 1 in 4 people struggle with this. In the US, millions of people have non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, and they're told for the most part, don't worry about it, just live with it, it's okay. Well, I don't know about you, but my liver wasn't designed to be fatty, and the thought of fat clogging up my liver, considering how important the liver is not something that I'm okay with. And if you or a loved one was told that you have a fatty liver, the research is clear that you have a couple underlying health problems going on that you need to address. Number one is obesity. Number two is that fatty liver is associated with insulin resistance or prediabetes. You have blood sugar problems. Fatty liver disease is associated with metabolic syndrome, high blood pressure, abdominal obesity, too much bad cholesterol and not enough good cholesterol. And fatty liver disease is also seen in patients with hypothyroidism. And that's what we're going to talk about today. Now, when it comes to hypothyroidism, some studies looking at hypothyroidism have found that it is an independent risk factor for non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. This means that blood pressure could be great, cholesterol could be great, blood sugar could be great, insulin could be great, but yet because you have thyroid disease, that alone is enough to be causing fat to accumulate in your liver. Now, this doesn't surprise me at all because I did a video and wrote several articles about this years ago where I talked about the relationship between thyroid hormones increasing cholesterol production in the liver. And if you saw that video or read my article then on thyroid disease and heart disease, it's probably no surprise that either of these conditions are associated with fatty liver. So the research shows that even subclinical hypothyroidism increases the risk for fatty liver disease. And subclinical hypothyroidism, also called mild thyroid failure, is diagnosed when your TSH levels are elevated, but your T3 and T4 levels are normal, right? And so again, that's considered mild thyroid failure. Now, what I found interesting when I looked at the studies is that when you look at them in numbers, you start seeing that the higher the TSH is, the higher the likelihood of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. Now, one thing I'll talk about, and I've talked about in a lot of my videos, is the importance of T3 thyroid hormone. T3 thyroid hormone basically, that the thyroid gland makes T4 and T3. And T4 needs to be converted into T3 in the liver, kidneys, and gut. And T4 doesn't do much in your body, but T3, on the other hand, that's the active form of thyroid hormone, and that does everything. And here's why thyroid hormone levels are so important to you, and especially if you have a fatty liver. When decreased levels of T3 are inside your cells slow down, your mitochondria slow down, and their ability to make energy is slowed down. That means fatigue, brain fog, and weight gain. When T3 levels are low, your cells aren't turning glucose into energy. And if the mitochondria can't burn glucose as fuel, we have this building up, and that ultimately over time, if you check your blood work, begins to show up with high blood sugar, high levels of insulin, and high triglyceride levels. That extra glucose floating around in your blood can't be used by your liver and your muscles, so your body converts it into triglycerides, and eventually when triglycerides are all stored up, it gets converted into fat that gets stored around the belly. Insulin resistance is a problem that starts in the liver, and so the more insulin resistant you become, the more likely you're going to start developing chronic inflammation in your liver. Well, this causes another problem for people with thyroid disease. Inflammation is your thyroid's worst enemy. With this inflammation, our bodies become terrible thyroid converters, meaning we don't convert T4 into T3 the way we're supposed to. And the end result is low T3, and your liver can't work properly when you have low T3 levels. Thyroid hormones are essential for liver function and liver metabolism, and having low thyroid hormones promotes fats depositing in the liver. And also, two very important ways non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, again, remember, it starts with blood sugar and it starts with low thyroid hormone levels. The link between fatty liver disease and thyroid disease is clear that, once again, the earlier you detect it and diagnose it and treat it, the likelihood of preventing the development of fatty liver and preventing the progression of it is increased. In other words, it's not going to happen. But here again, modern medicine is failing diabetics and it's failing thyroid patients time and time again. So what can you do to take back control of your health and get control over this fatty liver? Well, number one is if you have weight to lose, you have to lose weight. Diet, exercise, balancing hormones. You got to reduce your stress levels because stress is terrible for your thyroid. It triggers inflammation. It causes high cortisol, causes gut problems. You need to work on converting T4 to T3. Whatever those problems may be for you, you need to become a better converter. You need to make sure that you're sleeping good because sleep is where our bodies heal and repair, especially the thyroid gland. You need to make sure that you're cutting out processed foods and sugars. Follow an anti-inflammatory diet like a Mediterranean diet or a paleo diet. You need to reduce free radicals and oxidative stress. So you need to take supplements that are high in antioxidants. You need to address any subclinical infections because many times subclinical infections are at the root of people's immune, inflammatory, and autoimmune issues. You need to optimize your blood sugar and any problems with insulin resistance. And lastly, you need to address any issues with toxicity. When the liver gets compromised, as in the case of a fatty liver, it can't detoxify all of the toxins that we're constantly being bombarded with, okay? So there you go. If you have any questions about today's video or the relationship that your thyroid has with fatty liver, be sure to drop them in the comment section below. Again, I'm gonna do my best to answer those for you if I see them. Make sure you check out some of the other videos that pertain to this topic. Again, I'll leave those in the description box. If you're interested in working with my clinic, you can reach out to me by visiting my website. And lastly, if you like today's video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you like it. And again, I recommend that you watch a couple of these other videos that I put together on this topic as well.